What's up, guys? TheDevildogGamer here, and we're back with some Rainbow Six Siege with the DLC Red Crow. And once again, I'd like to thank Ubisoft for sponsoring this video. If you want to check out Red Crow or Rainbow Six Siege, check the link in the description below. It's amazing. You won't regret it. Anyways, boys, on top of the new operators, we have a new map, Skyscraper, and a few other goodies, including elite uniforms. We're going to talk a little bit about the elite uniforms, some of the new skins, weapon skins we get, and then we'll move on to the map, which is awesome. First things first, we get new skins for all the new operators, for Echo and Habanya. A lot of them are Japanese-based, which is pretty cool. I mean, you get this, like, orange skin here that, it almost looks like leather. With a bunch of symbols, and then like the wrapped handguard that looks like a like a samurai sword. You get a bunch of different ones like this. This is one of the ones right here, the Doe. And then you get the Tribunal. That actually looks kind of cool. I might grab that one real quick before I forget about it. I'm a skin freak when it comes to different stuff. And you get charms, your charms, of course. Where are their little charms? I'll have to look around for them a little more. But yeah, you get new skins there. I like this pistol skin. It's pretty cool. Which one is this one? Tentacles. Oh, I hope I'm not the only one who got that joke. Damn, Ubisoft. You funny. You funny, Ubisoft. Actually, I haven't looked at headgear. You get this little snake mask, and this little snow mask for Echo. I like the snake mask. I think it looks pretty cool. And your uniforms, you go from this, you know, a bunch of different ones to this, like, ninja-looking one to the police blue. I prefer this little, it almost looks like a Flecktarn, kind of. I don't know what camo it is. If you know what camo that is, let me know. Paratrooper, apparently is the name of it. Habanya. She has a bunch of different weapon skins. I like the shotgun one, the pirate one. I think that's a cool looking skin. We haven't put one on the pistol. Let's actually do that right now and see what they got. Of course, we got tentacles, and then we have the Moku. That's cool. It actually has the grip, just kind of like the samurai sword again. That's a pretty cool skin. I'm enjoying that. Let's do that. And then the red for the Type 89 is pretty legit. The Ka. And then you have the Type 89. Oh, that looks like a Gundam almost. Okay, let's grab that one up. That skin looks like it's a, like a Mobile Suit Gundam, like the actual skin for it, or an airplane or something like that. But I don't know, that's the first thing that came to my mind. Whatever, I'm weird. So you got all the little weapon skins for the new operators. They're quite cool. Let's go to uniforms. She has the same uniforms as Echo. I keep with the little camouflage one. And then headgear, she also has this little face mask. What's the difference? Oh, it's a different colored hood. Yeah, but I like the slicer one. I think that's pretty cool. Alright, so on top of that, we have new elite uniforms. Now, I think there's 3 operators that have them so far. I'm sure they're going to add more. I think they're awesome. Definitely adding more customization to the game. I jumped on them immediately. We're going to start with my favorite one, which is Capcan. This is Capcan's elite uniform. All, like, Soviet, Afghanistan-era uniform. Now, when you unlock these, it unlocks a ton of stuff. Charms, all kinds of stuff. It's really cool. I think this is a badass skin that he has. On top of that, he has a nice little skin, which is pretty cool. It makes everything, like, wooden, pretty much straight up. Soviet steel is what it's called. It looks pretty much like you would see a Soviet-issued weapon. Let's see what it looks like for the Saiga. Even though I like the Saga skin. There it is. Ah, I like that. That's cool. I think his skin is by far the coolest one. It literally looks like VDV fucking Soviet invasion of Afghanistan skin. I think that's cool. The next awesome one is Sledge. He has like a World War II kilt fucking ball sledgehammer. That thing's amazing. I haven't checked out his skins, weapon skins for it, so let's go do that. Let's see what he has. Ferrum. That's pretty cool. But of course, you gotta go with the Union Jack skin. No, I'm kidding. I should start using the Union Jack skin. Would you guys want to see it? Yeah, you would. You want to see the Union Jack. And then we got See, that's cool. I like just the plain Jane. I think that's awesome looking. And of course, the SMG-11, which no longer has an ACOG. A lot of people are upset about that. I like that. That thing's cool. Actually, no, it's Smoke who lost the ACOG, I believe. Nope, I think it's just around the board for the SMG-11. So he has a... Actually, let's see. Does his headgear change at all with this? Yeah, it's specific. So it kind of loads it out with the specific skin for it. And then you get a special skin here. There. You get his little special charm. His little chibi. So I think that's pretty cool. I like the new skins. The elite skins. And then we have one for Thermite, which is pretty legit. It's like an old school FBI police motorcycle skin. You can't beat it. It looks so legit. And then it just makes the guns all plain Jane, which are awesome. I quite enjoy that. I think this is a badass skin. It would have been cool if we had a leather holster for the pistol, though. That would have been cool. But yeah, these are awesome skins. I like them. It's definitely going to add to more variety to it. The more you can customize your operators, the better. I feel like that would be just a really cool aspect of it. But anyways, these are the new operators, the new skins. Let's talk about the new map. The new map Skyscraper is pretty cool. If you've ever seen the movie Wolverine, it has that feel to it, that old meets new Japanese. It has like samurai armor around and then holographic cities and just other crazy things around it. It is, I believe, a two level, but the crazy thing is one of the start points that is down is actually way lower than it, and you actually have to rappel up a large wall. Which is cool, it gives it the actual feel of it being a skyscraper. Then you have another start point, which is a helipad, and then from there, it's just another area, a secondary building. It has like a courtyard, balconies all around the two levels, and then like little gardens and stuff like that. There's a few points you can hang back and actually snipe from the outside through windows if you want. But a lot of the walls are breakable, so that's one of those things that, you know, you're starting to have to get used to. Your entire team's gonna have to put down barricades or you're gonna have a bad time. A very bad, very bad time. Especially with Hibania now, this is kind of her map, really, because there's so many areas you can smash and completely destroy that, like, you know, you're kind of gonna need her, at least. But yeah, this map is pretty cool. There are, the samurai armor is a cool feature to it. There's actually a few Easter eggs with it to where the samurai armor has little medallions of the Assassin's Creed logo, which is cool. And then there's the Division game, actual game case, and a few other little Easter eggs around here and there. But the breakable walls are crazy. There's a lot of shoot walls you can shoot through. But the cool thing about it is the samurai armor. So the samurai armor, when you're peeking through windows, and if you don't know the locations of them, you see them and you automatically think there's someone. I caught a lot of people shooting at them. I was shooting at them a lot myself. It's just kind of one of those things that it's there to draw fire. You're going to end up shooting at it a bunch of times. There's a few areas with balconies overlooking the staircases, which is a nice little Overwatch point because staircases are always hard to transition through. Now with balconies overlooking the staircases, not only are you going to have to watch the top of the staircase, but you're going to have to watch the balcony. Those are going to be hard points to transition through. There's also a drum in one room that you could hide on the roof, the overhang on the back side of it, and see the little lobby entrance down below at the same time you're covering behind you in the transition point, the little transition hallway. That's a pretty cool spot, especially for Echo if you want to hide and do your drone there. And then just wait for people to come around. That's a cool spot. I'm actually liking that spot a lot. I'm going to use it a lot more. I've only used it once to not much success, but we're going to have to go through it and see really what the best spots are. A lot of defensible points, a lot of weak points. This seems like it's going to be a tough map to learn and defend with. A lot of windows, but a lot of the exterior walls aren't breakable. A lot of these brown and tan walls, you can't really smash through at certain points, which is cool because, you know, it kind of adds that extra layer to outside. But inside, It's a completely different ballgame. Almost every wall is smashable, shoot through. Tachanka's going to have a field day if you set up a great Tachanka. Especially now that the map's new. Throw down Tachanka because literally nobody knows what walls are shootable. So this would be your time to get, like, you know, an entire ace with the mounted gun. So that would be your thing. It's crazy. It's a cool map. I'm really liking the new maps. I like having to learn because everybody knows the maps now. So it's pretty cool to go through and learn the new maps and not have everybody familiar with them. You know what I mean? So it's like you call out somewhere and somebody's like, I don't know where that is. That's pretty cool. There is one bathroom that a lot of people seem to hide in and I like to hide in. The bathroom stall, but once you're in there, I suggest not hiding in there because you're literally stuck, and you're just gonna get smoked. But I've had gotten a few kills in there. The bathroom's kind of one of those places you shouldn't be hiding in. Don't hide in the bathroom. Join the fight. Anyways, boys, if you want to check out my video on the operators, check it out. It's popping up in an annotation right now. Don't forget to check out the link in the description below if you want to see some more Rainbow Six Siege Red Crow. And if you guys want to see more Rainbow Six Siege in general, let me know in the comments below. Talk to you guys later. Peace.